One man with cerebral palsy struggled to eat his own food. As a result, he required help from his mom when they went out on Memorial Day. However, nothing could prepare them for what would happen next. Hello, wonderful people. I'm Jamie Buck from WonderBot. And here is... Waiter stops to help man with cerebral palsy who has trouble eating in act of kindness. Before we begin, make sure you smash the like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification bell for more amazing videos. There have been numerous times when Lee has felt like a burden. Despite living with cerebral palsy, the honorary Marine is determined to live a normal life. However, even seemingly simple tasks can be challenging. When he went to a restaurant with his mother, one waiter changed everything. A life-changing dinner. Lee has had cerebral palsy for as long as he can remember. It has pretty much affected every aspect of his life. Many people with the condition will agree that it can be extremely difficult to perform even the most ordinary tasks. However, Lee is now in his 50s, and he's managed to make a life for himself, despite having the disability for most of his life. He might not want help, but when he gets it, he is more than grateful. Living with a disability. One thing is for sure, no matter what challenges come Lee's way, he knows how to approach it with a smile on his face. He very much looks at the glass as half full, and his mother, Linda, can certainly attest to this. Lee is such a positive person. He has never lost faith in his fellow man, Linda said. If anything, Lee lifts others up. This is not only coming from me as his mother. You could ask anyone at his job or a friend. Looking on the bright side. Although people with cerebral palsy can struggle to do things by themselves, Lee has worked hard to gain his independence over the years. Normally, he turns people down when they offer to help him with basic tasks. These include eating and carrying things. Seeing that he has such a positive outlook, he is very confident in his abilities. However, as optimistic as he is, Lee has often had to approach things from a realistic point of view, and for good reason. He wants to be independent. Probably the most challenging part of his condition is that Lee struggles to use his hands for many basic and important tasks. Even picking up food with utensils and putting it in his mouth can be a daunting task. This means that people close to him, like Mother Linda, are often tasked with having to personally feed him. She was once presented with the task when the pair went out for dinner on Memorial Day. He struggles to use his hands. Despite his disability, Lee has been a devout member of his community for many decades now. So much so that he ended up being an honorary Marine in a special ceremony. Lee is extremely patriotic, and had he been physically able, he most definitely would have served his country. The ceremony in which he was made an honorary Marine acted as a fundraiser for a charity of his choice. Make no mistake about it though, Lee is quite the workhorse. Honorary Marine. Despite the fact that he has cerebral palsy, Lee has still managed to hold down the same job for over a quarter of a century. He has worked as a store assistant at a local grocery store for many years, and for so long, has been regarded as one of the most loyal and dependable employees in the company. Although he loves going to work every day, Lee recently learned some news that he didn't want to hear. He loves his job. Although Lee is interested in retiring sooner rather than later, he didn't expect to lose his job as abruptly as he did. However, it had nothing to do with his performance. It turns out that the grocery store that Lee has been working at the last couple of decades was closing down, along with a number of other chains. I will really miss it. I'm really going to miss everyone doing my job, he said. It's like being with family here. Early retirement? While Lee was upset to lose his job, this story is about another chapter in his life. It's about the time he went to a restaurant with his mother Linda. The incident happened on Memorial Day, and the mother-son pairing was excited to enjoy some quality time together that weekend. In fact, this photo was taken when Lee took Linda out during Mother's Day. Then, when Memorial Day came around, he took her to the same place, dinner with Mom. The venue in which this remarkable story happened was at 42nd Street Oyster Bar, which is regarded as one of the most popular dining spots in Raleigh, North Carolina. It certainly wasn't the first time that Lee and Mother Linda had been at an excellent seafood restaurant. They couldn't wait to see what was on the menu and roll back the years on Memorial Day. However, as their food arrived, Lee's day started to go downhill. Where it all went down. Sadly, Lee's Memorial Day turned into a bag full of problems. Due to his cerebral palsy, he struggled to use his handles, meaning that by proxy, he was unable to feed himself. Sure, his mother was there to help in that situation. However, this then meant that while she fed him, she was unable to feed herself at the same time. Her food was getting cold. It didn't take long before someone stuck their head up and took notice. One of his bad days. From afar, a waiter who was known by his coworkers simply as Five saw what was happening. Five has been working at the restaurant for a couple of years now. He's also a college student who is using his job mainly to pay for his tuition fees. However, he is also one of the restaurant's top employees and can be seen in his day-to-day commitment and hard work. So when he saw what was happening, he knew exactly what to do. Busy waiter. As he looked up after taking someone else's order, Five the waiter noticed that Lee and his mother were struggling. Linda tried her best to feed her son, while Lee was adamant that he wanted to do it himself. It was clear that Five was uncomfortable with how things were playing out. At that moment, the waiter reacted in a way that nobody, not even Lee, could have anticipated. He rushed over to the table and completely turned the evening on its head. He took notice. As he walked over to the table, the waiter greeted Lee and Linda and asked them how they were doing. Then, Five asked a question that completely took them by surprise. He casually came over and asked Lee if he had ever had oysters, Linda said. Lee told him he had not. At that point, Five said, "Excuse me," and walked away. Lee and Linda were both confused. However, they'd only need to wait a few seconds before the waiter returned. "Have you ever had oysters?" When the waiter returned, he had a platter of oysters in one of his hands, and Linda explained what happened next. Five asked if he could serve him his first. It was smooth not to embarrass Lee, just offering to share in the experience. Naturally, Lee accepted his offer and let Five personally feed each oyster to him. He enjoyed every single bite and washed it down with a tasty beverage. Needless to say, Linda was lost for words. He personally served them to him. Lee's mother couldn't believe that Five would do something so kind and selfless. Customer service was one thing, but this took it to another level. For a total stranger to come up really touches a mother's heart, especially when your child has special needs, she said, not to mention the fact that he did not embarrass Lee in the process. This was certainly a unique waiter, and he explained why he did what he did in an interview. Heartwarming moment. While it could have been easy for another waiter to take all of the credit for his act of kindness, Five was simply concerned about his customer's dining experience. Seafood is best eaten hot, so I didn't want her food to get cold. I didn't want his food to get cold, he said. I just wanted to help a fellow man out. Linda and Lee were so touched by Five's gesture that they wrote about it on their Facebook account. Didn't want the food to get cold. When they got home, Linda shared a heartwarming photo of Five feeding Lee with the following caption. When you dine at 42nd Street Oyster Bar, please ask for a server by the name of Five, a college student. He saw me trying to eat and help Lee. He insisted on helping and showing Lee total respect. This lets me know that there are still decent and compassionate people left in our country. Pay it forward for Five. It was a matter of time before people took notice, sharing their story online. It didn't take long before Linda's post about what had happened traveled far and wide, attracting all sorts of positive reactions. However, it was Love What Matters who shared the post and turned the moment into a viral sensation. The post received a staggering 17,000 reactions, hundreds of comments, and 1,400 shares. As time went on, more and more people got talking about the waiter's act of kindness, and eventually Five, Lee, and Linda became the talking point of numerous news outlets. Before they knew it, Lee and everyone else involved with the heartwarming moment started getting phone calls from numerous news outlets, and they were having interviews left, right, and center. In one interview, Lee was very vocal about how grateful he was to be served by Five. "That was the ultimate kindness he showed me," he said. "I really appreciate what he did, an act of kindness." And it wasn't just Lee who had good things to say about the waiter. They made the news. Of course, some of the people who were most proud of Five's act of kindness were his bosses. When reporters showed up to interview the waiter, he wasn't working. However, manager Ryan had the following to say about what had happened. "We're fortunate to have somebody like him working for us." Another manager claimed that he was just doing what he thought was the right thing to do. In fact, many others wanted to repay Five for what he did. His boss was extremely proud. Amazingly, Five doesn't even have access to social media, so he only found out that the story went viral later on. Nevertheless, he was overwhelmed by the positive reactions and received many letters from people all over the world. In fact, many people are giving the waiter all sorts of awesome offers to express their gratitude. I'm going into the gas station and somebody wants to buy me gas. I'm like, no, he said. However, the best was yet to come. Everyone wanted to help him. Since that awesome encounter, Lee has returned to the restaurant a number of times, most notably on his birthday. Once again, the waiter gave some top-class customer service to Lee, as well as his friends and family who were also there that evening. Lee and Five both admit that they have a new friend in each other. I'm glad I met Five. He's a real good friend of mine, Lee said. I'm very blessed. It shows that there are still good people in the world.